Hey everybody, Matt from Mule here. Time for Mule School. We're gonna talk a little bit about guitar setup. It's one of those things that us guitar makers haven't done a great job of explaining, and I think sometimes we can give the illusion that there's an infinite amount of possibilities and we can find just the right possibility for you, when really there's only three ways to set up a guitar. Knowing that and simplifying like that, hopefully will help you stop worrying about, kind of this unattainable feeling in the instrument and just playing guitar and practicing, okay? So, we're going to do it with a little handy diagram here. Okay, yeah, I'm going to put decimals into a fraction because I can do whatever I want. Also, when you start talking 64ths of an inch, sometimes you gotta do conversion in your head and blows everybody's minds. Okay, so what these numbers refer to are 32nds of an inch on the low E string. Okay, so this is 2/32 of an inch on the low E string. This is 3/32 of an inch on the low E string. Okay, so these are really the options on how to set up a guitar. Over here we have Instagram sweet pickers. It's gonna call them ISPs over here. This is not really a thing, 1.5. And we're gonna go over why here shortly. This is for electric guitars. This is for acoustic finger pickers and electric guitars. And this is for acoustic guitars. Lowest possible action is not the goal. In guitar making, there's always a balance of things. Okay? Everything that you do affects the instrument in some other way, and it's kind of the seesaw balancing act. Okay, when you lower the action, what you do is lose the ability to add inflection in your right hand, and that's what makes music dynamic. When you lower the action, you're not able to hit the strings as hard because you're avoiding fret buzz, so you lose volume. When you raise the action, you're able to hit the strings harder, which means that you have a higher max volume, which sounds more dynamic than compared to when you're playing softly. Okay. So you have to realize that is that getting the strings as low as possible, there's a trade-off there. Okay. A lot of times people will say, I want the lowest possible action, I want the lowest possible action, without really explaining what that means to them. When you look here, there's numbers, okay? There's really only three numbers. We're just gonna ignore the Instagram sweet pickers, okay? And the way that you know your numbers is with this handy dandy Stumac string gauge. I'm not sure if this is gonna be centered in the video, but you can get these at Stuart McDonald for like $10 and you use this to measure the height of the strings. That way when you get a guitar that you like how it feels, you can measure it and you can tell your repair guy, hey, I want my guitar set up at 3/32 of an inch. As opposed to trying to ambiguously describe how you play and what you listen to. And then there's all sorts of like translation errors that happen because one thing for you might be different for me. Okay, these are numbers, you can measure it. These are numbers that you should know, okay? And as you can see, is there's only three options here because as soon as you start getting into the middle of these numbers, you're talking 128,000ths of an inch. And if we're talking 128,000ths of an inch, we're really wasting time from actually playing guitar with things that don't really matter that much. Yes, there's outliers here. We have Instagram sweet pickers here, and above 3/32, we've got Charlie Hunter uses super high action. Yngwie Malmsteen actually uses super high action, even though he's a sweet picker. Hendrix, Stevie Ray Vaughan, lots of guys use super high action because it gives them that inflection. It makes things musical. Get yourself a string action gauge so that you know your number, okay? We can't talk about guitar setup without bringing up truss rods. Don't touch them, Don't touch them. Truss rods are not action adjusters. Okay, they adjust neck relief. Neck relief is the bend of the neck. Okay, you adjust the truss rod and this bend goes up and down. That affects mostly the middle of the neck. Guitars are fretted and set up for a specific neck relief. That truss rod is only used to adjust the neck back to that original neck relief if it moves. If you don't know what that neck relief is because you didn't measure it, you really shouldn't touch the truss rod, because you can really go down a rabbit hole of chasing fret buzz. This is something that repair guys mess up all the time. Okay, you take your guitar in, you start telling them that you want action a certain way, and instead of adjusting it at the saddle, a quick fix is to try to make the truss rod make the neck do something that it's not designed to do. You adjust the action at the saddle. Electric guitar, resonator guitar, acoustic guitar, the saddle has to be adjusted. The saddle has to go up, the saddle has to go down. Okay, that's the only way. So, truss rod, not an action adjuster. Okay, so that's a quick overview of setting up the guitar. Hopefully that simplifies things a little bit. I want to kind of hack through some ambiguity in guitar making terms so that you're able to understand what expectations should be, and to kind of clear your mind of that that unattainable thing that might be standing in your way of playing, when it really comes down to this is really simpler than we make it out to be, and we should really just play guitar more. Okay, so Mule School setup. Thanks for listening to this big long rant. See you next time.